This is a question, really, that I like very much to pose to your consideration too, about the possibility of the existence of real gender identity in the Neolithic times of Iberian prehistory. Our aim is to analyze the other from the past in order to investigate the variability and social equity between feminine and masculine identities in the prehistoric past, until finding the moment where sexual equity, as a gender identity free of discrimination, could have existed, coming to the convergence point with the contemporary queer desire to the elimination of binary gender. I'm not a woman, I'm not a man, I'm a human being. We are aware of the limitations of the archaeological data and subjectivity inherent in interpretations. After all, we are part of our interpretation. And we are going to make a tour in past time. In a general overview, in the empirical records of the Argyric Bronze Age and late Iberian Southwest Bronze Age, emerged differentiated sex-gender identities. Women managed the domestic space while men dealt with the most productive sectors of economy, metallurgical activity, the sphere of political and coercive power, expressed in the ownership of weapons, luxury items, and heroic narratives engraved in funerary stelae, like this one we are seeing. Gender archaeology in Spanish prehistory, mainly in Andalusian prehistory, proposes an active and central role for women in the Argyric domestic space, like this reconstruction, connected with maintenance activities like food preparation, care practices, and textile production. Let's go to the Early Bronze Age or Belbica period in the second half of the sub-millennium CalBC. Did women become invisible? Archaeological literature have emphasized the male protagonism on metallurgical activity, alliance networks, warfare, mainly based on exceptional individual graves like those of Almesbury in UK, United Kingdom, and Quinta da Água Branca in the northern Portugal. And in the right, and I have a very well furnished Belbica man, and you can see in the lower part of the slide the goods that composed the Quinta da Água Branca votive elements. But women were there too. In some calcolithic macro-villages like Perdigão or Porto Rão in southern Portugal, there were women pit graves without any funerary goods. In other cemeteries in the region of Madrid, women graves generally display cupola walls, but in few cases they were furnished not only by walls but also by weapons. Cupa, palmela, arruets, and not only in unmarked pit graves, but in monumental burials like the funerary enclosure Bella Vista 5, we have already seen. A previous ditched settlement enclosure was transformed into a single monumental grave for a unique woman who was older than 30 years. I think this data supports the proposal of the existence of a multiple femininities and masculinities in the early Bronze Age. A binary gender model proposed by some scholars for the second half of the third millennium BC, where all the social power and wealth were in the hands of men, is being contested in some years, namely by Alice Rogers, who studied 246 women burials from 116 necropolis in UK and concluded that female funerary rituals were complex and variable, mainly by age. So, being female was not be part of an homogeneous category. Women were active members of communities, and in some cases they had been buried with the so-called weapons. We cannot assume a strict division of male and female artifacts influenced by our cultural patterns inherited from the 19th century. Let's step back in time. The ambiguity and interchangeable feminine and masculine sexual attributes of several Chalcolithic figures from the first half of the 3rd millennium BC in southern Iberia are telling stories of exchangeable functions performed both by women and men. So, for example, the idol, the figure, the ivory idol from the Chalcolithic site of Malagon, it has a feminine body, but he has a masculine attribute clearly expressed. So there are this ambiguity. It's very characteristic of the images from the Chalcolithic period of southern Iberia. Ideological representations with sun eyes have bisexual connotations in the Chalcolithic, although at the first glance the cylinder idol supports the male concept. Female attributes can be perceived on it. Therefore, we have a synthesis of the masculine and feminine, which means the possibility of the existence of a deified hermaphrodite identity, a third gender. Two specific contexts now. One is the fortified settlement of Portas Carreiras in southern Portugal, in the bank of the Guadiana River, and from the first half of the 3rd millennium BC. The functional plan of this settlement showed that zones I and G were dedicated to weaving. In zone I, there was an engraved chest plaque among the concentrations of loom weights. This can be interpreted as a connection of weaving craft with the ancestor megalithic feminine divinity associated with death. A Tholos of Montelirio in Sevilla. The big funerary chamber revealed an extraordinary concentration of adult women, about 75% of the total buried individuals without non-adults. The funerary items were also notable with exotic items, supposedly ornamented clothes, with mineral, shell, and amber beads, ivory votive figures, gold, and huge amounts of cinnabrium. So everything was red. Bones. And this context has been interpreted as a tomb of women collective, of a women collective dedicated to religious functions, which opens a window to more plural and complex activities for women in late prehistory. A reconstruction. And from the Chalcolithic, one step back to the Neolithic. And we are arriving at the main point of at the main topic of my communication. There are a Neolithic foundational myth that shows sexual equality in the Middle Neolithic. In the megalithic schematic art, the expression of a probable foundation myth can be read in a menhir of Sagres, southwest corner of the Iberian Peninsula. And male and female are completely undifferentiated in the form of two similar snakes that came from Earth, and the egg of life emerged from their copula. And in the other side, you can see another expression of the same myth in the painting from the Dolmen de Dentelles, where we can see also the two snakes. And for conclusion, in the late prehistory, after Bronze Age, with the emergence of the state, Argaric state, or late Southwest Bronze Age state, we can root a probable binary gender social organization with male dominance connected with the control of plow agriculture and political power. Metallurgy and political power. Although it is a very general and hypothetical picture, it doesn't show the whole reality that archaeological record has been revealing. Even if the accessible past is limited and fragmented, we can suppose for the Neolithic Iberian societies a more diverse and balanced sex gender scenario, where multiple genders or a zero gender situation could have existed. Thank you very much.